In this video, we're going to work with a definition and a few examples of closed sets. Remember that if you want to support the channel, you can do so with a very small donation on Ko-fi. You can also support us on Patreon to get exclusive content and merchandising. Or you can buy mathematics t-shirts in our store. So what is a closed set? The definition is actually very simple, but it can be a bit confusing. We have a topological space X, and we say that some set A is closed if its complement is open. But now it's important to see where the complement is taken. That is the reason why I'm not just writing X A complement, because things will get a bit more tricky when we start working with subsets of topological spaces. So let's start with a very simple example. That is, we have the real line with the standard topology, and we just consider, for example, the set 0, 1. You can probably already imagine what this set is because it's called the closed set, so it doesn't actually leave us with a lot of options. So to prove that this set is closed, we would have to see that the real numbers minus 0, 1 is open. Well, what is R minus 0, 1? This set is the minus infinity 1 open union 1 infinity, and we know that these two sets are open, and so the union of open sets is also open. So the real numbers minus 0, 1 is an open set, and so 0, 1 must be closed. What happens if we consider another topology? For example, let's suppose we have a set X, and we consider the topology of parts of X, that is the discrete topology. In this topology, we know we have every set, and so every set is open. But if I take any set A, subset of X, if I want to see if A is closed, I would have to do X minus A. But because we are in the parts of X topology, then X minus A is obviously in parts of X. So this tells us because the complement is an open set, then A is closed. But because A is a subset of X, then A is an element in parts of X, and so A is open. So it can happen for a set to be both open and closed, and that is actually what happens, for example, with in any set with any topology. What happens with the set itself and the empty set? Well, if I want to see, for example, that X is closed, I will have to do X minus X. This is the empty set that is obviously in my topology, because topologies have to satisfy this, and so X is closed. But also X is in the topology, and so X is open. And the same happens with the empty set. X minus the empty set is X, and X is an element in the topology. So the empty set is closed. But again, the empty set is also in the topology, which shows us that the empty set is open. So sets can be only closed, like here the 0, 1 is closed and it's not open. They can be just open, like these intervals here. But if we change topologies, we can have examples of sets that are both open and closed. Well, now let's see an example that will complicate things a little bit. And that is, what happens when we consider the subspace topology? So let's imagine that our set X will be the real numbers, and we take a subspace 0, 1, union 2, 3. So this is our whole set, and our subspace is going to be this interval and this other interval. So now, whenever we talk about open and closed sets, we have to say with respect to which space we're talking about. Because we saw, for example, that 0, 1, the interval, is closed with respect to X. But is it closed with respect to Y? Now remember that on Y we are considering the subspace topology. So our open set will be always the intersection of y with an open set of, in this case, the real line. And I can actually write 0, 1 as an intersection, for example, of some set like this. This set AB is an open set in the real line, and the intersection with y is giving me 0, 1. So, for example, I can take the set minus 1 half, 3 over 2, because this was number 1 and this is number 2, and take the intersection of this set with y. This intersection gives us 0, 1, and thus showing that 0, 1 is open. But is open on y. This is very important because 0, 1 is not open on x. But because we could write it as the intersection of our space y with an open set of the real numbers, then we can say that it's open on y. And the same happens with the interval 2, 3. We can write it as the intersection of some set intersection y. 2, 3 was actually open in the real line. Moreover, will it be open on y? So likewise, we have 2, 3 open. I asked if this set was closed in y, and my answer was, well, it's open. But this we know doesn't really answer things, because here we had examples of sets that were open, but were also closed. So to know if a set is closed, what we have to do is take the complement in the space where we want to see if it's closed or not. So in this case, it would be y minus the 0, 1. This is 2, 3. And 2, 3, we just said, was an open set. So this tells us that 0, 1 is closed in y. And also, we can do the same for 2, 3. Our subspace minus 2, 3 gives us 0, 1. And we said that 0, 1 was open. So this shows that 2, 3 is closed in y. So we can see that even if the definition of a set being closed is very simple, determining whether a set is open or closed can be very challenging because it depends on the topology that we are working with and the space. In the next video, we will learn more properties about closed sets.